to Blessed Sacrament Catholic Church. Today we celebrate the 25th Sunday of Ordinary Time. A reminder to all parents, as a precaution due to coronavirus, the cry room for small children is closed. We ask you to please accompany your child to the restroom if they need to go. At this time, please silence all cell phones and electronic devices. Our celebrant today is Bishop David, Father David. We begin by praying together the diocesan prayer for vocations. Please stand. O God, hear our prayer, and let our cry come to you. Bless our diocese of Savannah with many vocations to its priesthood, diaconate, and religious life. Give the men and women you call the light to understand your gift, and the love to follow always in the footsteps of your priestly son. Amen.
Please join in singing our opening song, Here I Am to Worship.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and the Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come again with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way and the wicked his thoughts. Let him turn the Lord for mercy to our God, who is generous and forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, life is Christ, and death is gain. If I go on living in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me, and I do not know which I shall choose. I am caught between the two. I long to depart this life and be with Christ, for that is far better. Yet that I remain in the flesh is more necessary for your benefit. Only conduct yourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landlord saw others standing idle in the marketplace and said to them, "You too go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off, and he went out again around noon and around 3 o'clock and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon his laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought that they would receive more. But each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give the last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Thus the last will be first, and the first will be last." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Many of us who have worked for companies are familiar with human resources. In today's gospel, HR would not have been happy with what the landowner had done. They would have said it wasn't acceptable to pay the last, the same as the first. We know back in the time of our Lord, HR did not exist. There was no department to tell us what was just and what was unjust. Yet people had a sense of what was fair and what was unfair. Day workers were given a daily wage of 1 denarius. The work day was sunrise to sunset. So naturally, it was only fair that those who worked less than a full day should receive less. But in today's parable, the landowner has pity on those who could not find work throughout the day. They had families they had to feed. It was not their fault that no one hired them. Therefore, he hires them, some of them even a few hours before sunset, and gives them all the same daily wage. He is not being unjust to those hired in the early morning. He is being charitable, merciful to those hired at the end of the day. Justice and mercy are compatible when charity is involved. "Are you envious because I am generous?" the owner says to those hired at sunrise who protested that they did not receive more. The exact translation of this is, "Do you view my actions with an evil, jealous eye?" Properly applied to the point of today's parable, the Lord is saying, if you begrudge generosity to the less fortunate, then you cannot be a Christian. If we do not rejoice in the benefits given to others, then we cut ourselves off from the benefits we have received. As Christians, We are obligated to care for the poor. We need to establish governmental and private means to aid those who cannot help themselves. Yes, these agencies must be regulated to eliminate those who abuse them. That is justice. Our main concern must be to care for those who have less. That is mercy. Are you envious because I am generous? Envy and jealousy are horrible. The jealous person looks for ways to destroy another person's life. The jealous person usually ends up destroying their own life. The jealous person does not appreciate his own gifts. He can only see the gifts that others have. Everybody is different. Every situation is different. No two people are the same. No two situations are the same. We cannot compare or contrast others to ourselves. How is this parable applied to our relationship with God? God loves the person who is faithful throughout their life. He loves the person who strays for a time and then returns to Him. He loves the person who comes to Him in the twilight of their lives. Many people respond to God's mercy at different times in their lives. God's love for them, for taking the huge step away from their former lives, and for falling into the arms of His mercy. It is a tremendous step of humility to turn from a sinful life and turn toward God. God loves those who take this step, even though they join St. Augustine in mourning. Late have I loved you, O beauty ever ancient, ever new. Late have I loved you. What matters is that they are with Him now. They love God now. God loves those who practice their faith throughout their lives, and He loves those who return to the faith. We rejoice in those who join the faith or return to their faith. We don't consider ourselves superior to them because we are not superior to them. At the end of our gospel reading, we come upon the phrase, "The first shall be last, and the last shall be first." We cannot impose our ways on the Lord. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. We cannot tell God how to be God. We must do our best to respond to the call to labor in God's vineyard as we have received it. That call demands that we are open to God's mercy in our lives and that we become vehicles for God's mercy in the lives of others. This is Christianity. To act otherwise is to begrudge God for His generosity, to look upon God's goodness with an evil and jealous eye. The parable calls us to ask God to help us be vehicles of His mercy. When we look at our fellow men and women, when we look at our neighbor, do we see Christ working in them? Do we pray for them? Are we merciful to those we come in contact with, showing God's mercy to all throughout the world? God is merciful. He is patient. He is kind. Do we show that same patience and mercy and kindness to our neighbors? May we strive every day to show the same mercy to others that God shows to us.
the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified,
who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
God is our helper who sustains and sanctifies our life. With confidence in our Father's unfailing love, we ask him.
That the church may welcome all who come to the Lord's vineyard, whoever they are and whatever the hour, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For greater stewardship of creation, that God will impel our hearts to oppose the misuse of the earth's resources and empower us to work tirelessly to protect the magnificence of nature for future generations, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we who reap the fruits of the labors of migrant workers may also be sensitive to the dangers of their plight, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That educators and students may engage issues of social responsibility and justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this Eucharistic assembly may be the gospel's model of community, in which there are neither first nor last, but only sisters and brothers in Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who approach death and those who have died, especially Butch Lowenthal, who died this week, and Father Harry Flynn, whose anniversary we celebrate, and for Father Jeremiah McCarthy, for whom this Mass is offered, may ever proclaim that to live is Christ and to die is gain. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for Bishop-elect Parks, may God continue to strengthen him as he begins his ministry here in our diocese. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, thank you for the countless proofs of your gentleness. May we always praise your name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please join in singing our offertory song, 10,000 Reasons.
Sing like never.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of
celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Stephen, our Bishop-elect, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Father Jerry, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For those who are at home and cannot receive communion at this time, we will pray our spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I choose to be one with you, Jesus. I want your heart next to my heart, your soul next to my soul. Your body inside my body and your blood running through my veins. I want your infinite divinity to fill me completely. Jesus, I want to be one with you in my thoughts, feelings, and desires, in what I say and do and what I do not do because of you. I embrace you now inside of me. Jesus, I love you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
please join in singing the communion song, O Come to the Altar.
Before we conclude our Mass, again, I encourage you to take home a copy of our parish bulletin to see what's going on in our parish community. I'd like to welcome any newcomers or visitors to our parish community. Thank you for choosing Blessed Sacrament to celebrate the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass. Today's second collection is for the Seeds of Change Building Fund. Thank you for your continued support and generosity. There will not be a 5:30 p.m. Mass nor afternoon confessions on this Wednesday, September the 23rd,
since all priests will attend the ordination of Bishop-elect Stephen Parks. If you'd like to watch, the ordination will be live streamed at 1 p.m. on the Cathedral Basilica's website. Please let us know if you'd like to have the Living with Christ Sunday Missal. We've already received many requests. You can use these missals every Sunday and in the major feast days all year long. Plus, they make good Christmas gifts or personal prayer books. Only $5 each. Please sign up. Please use the sign-up sheet in the back of church or call or email our parish office. The Parish School of Religion for grades 1 through 8 is beginning. All children who do not attend Catholic schools should attend our Parish School of Religion, and there is still time to register. Please contact Garrett Savigal at her email listed on the back page of the bulletin. The RCIA program, Rite of Christian Initiation of Adults, begins this week on September the 22nd. For those interested in becoming Catholic or would like to learn more about Catholicism, classes are Tuesday evening, 7 to 8:30 p.m. until Easter. Please register for RCIA by contacting Brandon Wallace. His email is on the back page of our bulletin. The Bible study Walking with Jesus is beginning and space is still available. Choose either Tuesday mornings from 8:30 to 10:30 a.m. or Wednesday evenings from 6:30 to 9 p.m. The Bible study runs through November 17th, meeting in the parish office conference room. Contact Angela Strait for details. The Seeds of Change is once again offering bricks in honor of your loved one or student. Your donation of $125 for a legacy brick supports the Seeds of Change capital campaign. Order deadlines are October the 1st. Please fill out a form in the back of church or in the parish office. As always, please remember to take your bulletins with you. We cannot reuse them. Please do not leave them in the pew. We get a few people after Mass to help to sanitize the pews for the next service. It would be greatly appreciated. Thank you for all your support and cooperation. Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord with your life.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast to hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Have a blessed evening.
Please join in singing our closing song, Run to the Father.
Thank you.